Lumens, the big Belichick, give him a couple of weeks here. Oh, unbelievable. We have to go out of our way to win a Super Bowl against the Falcons. Yeah, see, you're shaking your head over there.
I know what you guys are doing. This ain't setting up all this. Well, obviously the Patriots are going to win, so it's this big shocker, and then...
I'm setting it up?
Just like with the Giants.
How am I setting this up?
Right, it was just such a foregone conclusion that the Patriots are going to beat the Giants, and when you're on Letterman, you say, I like the Giants, and we were all like, what, is he crazy?
Yeah.
Giants are never going to win.
Yeah.
Yeah, look what happened.
Yeah.
See what's happening here.
I'm just pointing it out here. It's a foregone conclusion. Nobody's giving the Falcons any chance here. You know, Brady's broken all these records. He's going to have his fifth. He'll be the greatest quarterback of all time. He's the difference between maybe being the greatest quarterback of all time or being the greatest quarterback defensively. This game. If Brady loses this game, is he the greatest quarterback of all time? He'd be 4-3 in the Super Bowl. I don't know. Feels like that, I guess. He's the greatest quarterback of all time. But if he only has four, but he's been to 7 Super Bowls, that's still pretty impressive.
Why isn't the 7 enough?
I don't know. But he lost 3 of them. Lost 3 of the big ones. It just feels like if he gets his 5th, he's 5-2, greatest quarterback of all time. Play 4-3, I don't know. There's still a little doubt there. Yeah, Paul.
Do you hear a report that the Patriots may have the victory parade this weekend so the players don't have to come back from Houston?
Now, it's nice. It'd be a little more convenient. Have it as they go to the airport. Have the victory parade. Is that an actual laugh or is that a sound effect? That's an actual laugh.
Is that geese?
Let me hear that again. Sounds like a
rocket beat. That's Fritzy. You think it should be universally accepted that Brady wins the 5th ring, that there's absolutely no argument he's the greatest quarterback?
Well, there's always going to be an argument. Montana's 4-0. Never threw an interception. MVP 3 times. It's generational here. Now, what you're arguing. And although I will say this, that when we think about Montana, you don't bring in Walsh the way we bring in Belichick with Brady. But Brady couldn't have done it without Belichick. I think people forget Joe Montana was fortunate to have an unbelievable coaching staff. Look at that coaching tree that he had in the Niners. Yes, McLeod.
Just don't call him assistant quarterback.
No,
you know,
no.
Nothing like that.
I've never seen him unraveled or even tense or upset, anything but in a jovial mood until that day when you said, I think you're assistant quarterback. And Montana, like, turned at you and is like, who the hell are you?
Did he say, I love my system, right? Technically, by the way, I didn't say it. You said it.
I didn't say it.
No, I did say it before. And yeah. He said, hey, Joe, this guy called you assistant quarterback.
He went, huh?